station that's on your side. This is News 12 at 6 o'clock.
The calmness of the course ahead of the roar of the galleries next week. We're going to look at a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity at Augusta National coming up here on News 12 at 6 o'clock. And some wild video out of Aiken, a car speeding away from police smashes into a woman's bedroom. It happened in the middle of the night. But we begin with a trash alert you need to watch out for if you're planning on crossing the Savannah River from South Carolina heading into Georgia. Here's the view right now. It's bumper to bumper. South Carolina Highway Patrol says they're at an accident. This is at exit 11, so 11 miles from the state line on I-20 westbound heading toward Georgia, stretching about 2 miles long now, and it's going to be even worse on a Friday afternoon. Cars heading about 20 miles an hour right now, some of them at a standstill. But again, if you're trying to head from South Carolina into Georgia, from Aiken to Augusta, you may want to find a different route and avoid I-20 after a crash there. So, Riley, a big weekend in Augusta with the final round of the Augusta National Women's Amateur tomorrow. The weather might
have full forecast.
Our top story at 6 o'clock, a family's home destroyed in the middle of the night after a car smashed into it during a police chase. All of it caught on camera. After crashing into that home, the driver hops out and runs away. Shortly after, the car bursts into flames, making that home unlivable. Will Rio, live for us in the newsroom. And Will, what a scene over at Aiken. And you spoke with a woman who says the fire department told her there was minor damage. She says that is not the case.
Yeah, that's absolutely right. A crazy scene there. We could barely walk through the house without having to wear a mask because the smell of the smoke was so bad. Her bedroom was completely destroyed as well. They say that they've had so many issues on that road and that this police chase was not the first one either. In the quiet of the night,
it's just like, I felt like an earthquake.
The eyes of Gwen Thomas's house were rolling. Speed pursuit ended under Gwen's bedroom.
My heart stopped pounding real fast. I thought I was going to have a heart attack.
She is lucky.
It's just scary because I usually keep my grandbaby and we both sleep in that room.
Gwen is hard of hearing. It's hard to hear high-pitched noises like our phones, bells, and even cop sirens.
Well, this could have been really bad for you.
Yes, very bad.
Her bedroom went up in flames.
My life was spared.
But her room was not spared.
They said this was minor damage.
Minor damage.
In February, it was a different month, but the same story.
It flipped over. It was heading in my house, into my direction of my house.
Luckily for Terry Harmon, there was no cleanup needed. Both Harmon and Thomas say the newly paved road and warning bumps aren't keeping drivers alert.
We've had a lot of accidents down here.
So many, they both know the beat of the traffic.
Because every time somebody be speeding over the railroad track, you hear them say, "Bloom, yeah, bloom, yeah." Every time, I'm like...
They hope something is done to ease their peace of mind.
Here at night, I'm tossing and turning, tossing and turning. I have nightmares. Like, I can't keep doing this.
Gwen told us that when she was a kid, they also had a house fire and lost everything, so it was hard for her to relive some of what happened. She says every time she hears a loud bump like that, she gets up, immediately runs to the door. What you saw in that video, that's exactly what she did. Gwen says that she does have a GoFundMe up right now to help fix her home so that she can get back into that house.
Some extensive damage over there. Will, thank you for the update there. 3 days now since a 13-year-old was shot and killed, grabbing a DoorDash order right outside his own apartment on Broad Street. Family in the community still waiting for answers on what happened to Buddy Brown. We asked the sheriff's office if they had a suspect or if the alleged killer was still on the loose or if the public is in any danger. We asked if they have any potential motives on why Brown was killed. All the sheriff's office is willing to say is that this is an active investigation, and otherwise they have no comment. Going to give you a live look at the Richmond Summit Apartments where Buddy Brown lost his life early Tuesday morning. Friends and family gathering there as we speak. They're going to hold a vigil for that 7th grade Hornsby Middle School student. Brown's parents say he loved being around his family. He was not a kid in the streets. They say they're going to do whatever it takes to find his killer. The family offering a $10,000 reward for information. So if you saw anything downtown that night or have any information on this killing, call the Richmond County Sheriff's Office. New this evening, a man in the hospital after a shooting today on Wiles Road. It happened just a couple of miles away from the Augusta Mall around 2 in the afternoon. Deputies expect that victim to be okay. Right now, there's no word on any suspects. With tens of thousands of people heading into town over the weekend, it'll be hard to avoid the traffic, especially on Washington Road. But when it comes to public safety, people expect the sheriff's office to do everything they can to keep us safe. Taylor Martin is live for us on Washington Road with plans on how they're going to juggle both jobs. Taylor?
From more police cars patrolling the streets, extra hours for deputies, and partnering with the Augusta National Police, the Richmond County Sheriff's Office says they have it all under control.
I'm not concerned about safety because our police force does such a wonderful job.
More traffic? No problem. At least it's the case for Nancy, who's lived in Augusta for 45 years.
I've learned where to go when and how to navigate it. And having been here all these years, I kind of know the back roads and it makes it a little easier.
For those concerned, the Sheriff's Office says, don't be. They'll be out in full force and then some. Not only near the Masters, but at nighttime, downtown, too.
Don't be concerned. We'll have plenty of police in the street, deputies in the street. The Augusta National, they hire a lot of deputies, not just our deputies, but we'll have deputies from all around the CSR area that will work at the Augusta National.
But you won't see any foot patrol deputies or any extra DUI enforcement during the week because of staffing shortages. Despite shortages in those areas, they say they're pushing through. And just like every year, they're ready.
We're just prepared. We are prepared. We always are. I think we have a good plan in place. I feel confident that it'll be successful. It has been for many years. We don't anticipate any issues.
For Nancy, she's ready for a fun and safe week.
She just knows to expect it. And it's, you know, such a wonderful event for our city.
The Sheriff's Office says traffic safety is their top priority when it comes to Masters Week. And as far as violent crime, well, they say it's their priority every day of the year, not just during Masters.
We know they have their work cut out for them, and we appreciate their early planning. Thanks very much for that, Taylor. This is the day the players of the Augusta National Women's Amateur have been looking forward to for a long time. The day their hard work pays off, they get to play on one of the most famous golf courses in the world. Laura Warren, live for us at Augusta National ahead of tomorrow's final round. Laura, bring us up to speed on an exciting day out there.
Such an exciting day, and let me tell you, Augusta National was showing off for these women today. The best weather, gorgeous, sun peaked out, just a slight breeze, but this is such a special day for so many of these women because whether they made the cut or not, they have the chance to play this historic course that so many have only dreamed of, and today they had the place to themselves. No patrons, just quiet, calm, peaceful, beautiful Augusta National out here today, and you could see even in the paths, not a single foot has been the grass in these walkways, so it was so quiet, you could almost hear what players were thinking out there. And for Gamecock Hannah Darling, those thoughts were much different than last year when she made the cut, but surprisingly in a good way.
Today was probably more special than last year for some reason. I really just tried to go out and enjoy the experience with, you know, my family and stuff like that, and yeah, it was really, really cool.
For so many of these women, it's their first time ever stepping on this course. They've seen it on TV for years. They've dreamed of playing, and the pinch me status out here is real.
It's been a crazy week. I don't want to go back home. I want to stay here for life.
I don't really get starstruck when I meet people, but the feeling of playing this golf course, I get starstruck. Like, it's hard to focus when I'm over a shot, and you know, I can think back to when I was watching on TV and just seeing people hit shots.
Listen, 10 years out here and I still get starstruck, so I can only imagine what these players are feeling. But I want to bring in sports director Dan Booth here because the leader has to be feeling something today. Rose Zhang trying to make history out here. She's entering the final round 13 shots under.
And her dad has been on the back for her every one of these years that she's played. And this is her third year playing in this event. And she came in today with the full intention of having a course caddy. But with knowing how well she's playing, why mess something like that up?
Ultimately, I feel like what we have is going pretty well thus far. And I feel very comfortable with him on the back. It's very predictable. We know our games in and out. So I think especially when you're
at the biggest stage at Augusta, it's pretty necessary to have that comfort, to be able to be yourself and do what you need to do.
The bond and comfort Zhang shares with her dad has certainly led to some positive results on the course, and I'll be excited to see how she fares in the final round. Zhang will continue her pursuit of history next to Andrea Lignell. Lignell is trailing Zhang by 5 strokes in second place. On the local front, UGA's Jenny Bay is coming into the final round in third place on the leaderboard at 7 under, with her tee time set for 8:40. West Columbia's Jensen Castle tees off just before Bay at 8:30, and she'll be looking to bounce back after an up-and-down performance in round 2. Now, the tee times for tomorrow are set, and what's interesting about this is the weather might play a factor tomorrow, just knowing where things are heading, and it's going to be interesting to see how they may play a role and potentially interrupt a couple things tomorrow, hence the early play times.
Right, they bump those up, so if they have to pause play, they have to get back out here, they have a little bit of flexibility. But Riley, everyone's hoping that maybe you guys will be wrong this time. How's it looking?
Yeah, guys, we are tracking the chance for storms tomorrow and potentially could even see some severe weather. For us here in Augusta, it peaks around lunchtime. We're going to have much more on the timing of those storms in that full forecast next.
And back to the golf course for another story, a bond only a father and daughter could have. Coming up, we'll show you how this duo is sharing it at Augusta National Golf Club.
Time Insta.
To play a round of golf at Augusta National is a dream come true, but to be able to share that experience with a person who spent years helping you with your game really is special. Our Alyssa Lyons caught up with the youngest player ever to make the cut at Augusta National Women's Amateur, and her dad turned caddy.
He's basically my best friend.
Like a caddy knows the lay of the green.
Sometimes it gets a little bit tough.
A dad knows his daughter like the back of his hand.
You know the player enough that when they're running hot, and my daughter does run hot, she's very competitive, to give her 20, 30 yards of space and just let her be, I mean, that's a fine line.
He's really good at calming me down. He knows me better than any other person does, and he knows exactly what I'm thinking in every single moment. So he knows me really well, probably a little too well at times.
We've worked pretty well together. I mean, for father-daughter, she's a teenager too, so we have our moments.
There are definitely moments where, you know, the dad comes out, which is understandable.
A lot of times me telling her, hey, gee, there's a hot mic right next to us, be careful.
From dad mode to caddy mode, everything in between.
We know exactly what we're thinking before we even say it, which we finish each other's sentences. We know the yardage before we even step up to the ball. We know what club we're going to say.
Little moments can turn into memories along the way.
I know a lot of kids, you know, they have a good relationship with their dad, but not necessarily in a caddy way. Some people like to keep it separate, but I think we do a really good job of kind of blending it all together.
In Augusta, Alyssa Lyons on your side.
And they tell us Gianna used an Augusta National caddy for that practice round this morning. She said she took notes at every turn, notes she'll be sharing with her dad at the dinner table this evening. So we appreciate them, and good luck to them this weekend. You know, golf can be contagious and getting easier for anyone to get their hands on. Coming up, a decision that could save a lot of lives.
If you think your accident
is possible,
get the strong arm.
When you look at the numbers on overdose deaths across the country, you get a better picture of just how bad it's gotten. Just over 20 years ago, fewer than 20,000 people died from an overdose. That doubled just 10 years later, more than doubling again in 2021. More than 105,000 people died from overdoses. This week, the FDA approving the life-saving overdose medicine Narcan for use without a prescription. Hallie Turner shows us how the decision can save lives.
It's been available in drugstores for years.
The most important thing is that the patients have it when they need it.
But not without a prescription.
You hit that overdose point, you know, and this person is, you know, turning blue, they're gurgling, or they stop breathing. We're talking seconds and minutes. We don't have time to run to the pharmacy.
But now, it's about to get a lot easier to get your hands on this life-saving drug. Working with Grovetown Police, William Loomer knows the importance of having naloxone on deck.
And on the successful applications that I've seen in my career so far, that's after it's taken us 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 10 minutes to get somewhere. But if that naloxone can be there within seconds, I mean, you can only imagine the increase in successful applications and the amount of lives saved would surely go up.
Wednesday, the FDA approved an over-the-counter version of the reversal drug naloxone. While doctors are excited for it, unknowns of cost, dosage, and if it will be a success remain.
Really tough question, and I don't quite know how it's going to play out, and the reason is because although it is over-the-counter, it's still going to have a cost.
Limmer says no matter the cost, when seconds count, you don't want to be without it.
To have some as a last resort type thing, you could have it in your house for loved ones. If you have somebody you're concerned about that you know maybe has a substance abuse issue, or you have a child experimenting with substances, you could have that naloxone in your house now.
Reporting in Augusta, Hallie Turner, On Your Side.
And there are still some questions about how many steps before this becomes official. The pharmacist and law enforcement both telling Hallie there are some steps for state approval as well. But the FDA hopes this could be on shelves by late this summer. Honoring a local legend while giving back to our community, this afternoon, UFC Aiken remembering Captain John Abshire with a special ceremony. He was an Army tank commander. Today, his wife announcing a scholarship in his name for ROTC students. The university says the strength of his legacy is not only what he brought to the lives of those on campus while living, but the impact he will continue having on generations of future military officers to come. New today, AU Health and WellStar announcing a new partnership. The two systems will go by the new name WellStar MCG Health. The two sides say the agreement will help strengthen medical training for students at the Medical College of Georgia and create better patient care for families. The partnership impacts several of our local hospitals, including the Children's Hospital of Georgia and the Georgia Cancer Center. All this still has to go through some approval process, and officials hope that will happen by late summer.
We do have the chance for storms heading our way tomorrow. We'll have another look at that forecast just after a short break.